Good afternoon guys, welcome to my second videos. In this second video I will explain about the function of cell membrane, and in the next video function of nucleus, and the last video I will explain the function about the cytoplasm. So in this video let us concentrate on the function of cell membrane. So as you have seen earlier in my first video that a cell membrane is the covering which covers the cytoplasm inside it. So if this yellow circle is the cell membrane, then this red one denotes the cytoplasm and the nucleus, and the blue one denotes the exterior. Okay, these are the exterior outside of the cell. So we can say this is the exterior part, blue one, and red one is the interior part of the cell. So whenever any molecule, say suppose this molecule, this black one, this molecule wants to enter inside the cytoplasm, it has to cross the cell membrane, is not it? See this position, it has to cross the cell membrane. So this entrance of molecule is restricted. Any molecule cannot enter inside the cell through the cell membrane. It has some restriction. So which molecule will enter and which molecule will not enter, this is solely depend on the nature of the cell membrane. That is why the cell membrane is called as the selectively permeable membrane. Means the cell membrane will select the molecules which will enter and which will not enter inside the cell. So this property is very important, because see, this molecule cannot enter, okay, and suppose this molecule it can enter, okay. So like this, the cell is allowing different molecules to come across it. This is the first function called as selectively permeability or selectively permeable membrane. Second function, cell, it is cells are having special kind of protein on it, okay. So these proteins are called as the integral protein. So let me try to show you one. If this is the part of a cell membrane, so here I am drawing with this. This kinds of proteins are there, okay. Actually cell is made up of proteins and lipids, glycoproteins, called as glycoprotein, glycogen and protein. So with this black I am showing you the lipids. These are the lipids, okay. These lipids are having some heads and the tails, which is a bilayer structure. You don't need in this class 7 or 8 standard, it is for class 10 or onward. Still just have the basic idea. The cell membrane, it is made up of glycogen and protein, okay, and lipids, glycogen, proteins and lipids, called as PLP, protein lipid protein, PLP, protein lipid protein model. Okay, now we got concentrated on it. Just simple know that the cell membranes are having special types of proteins on it. This one blue one, this is called as the, these are called as the integral proteins. These proteins are working as a receptor, you know, receptors, R-E-C-E-P-T-O-R-S. So these receptors are attaching with the different types of molecules, okay, different types of molecules, and promotes the biochemical reaction. So this is also one of the functions that cell membrane works as the receptors. Okay, here I mentioned here receptors, and these receptors are working to promote some biochemical reaction. For example, insulin. Suppose this red one is the insulin hormone molecule. So when this insulin hormone molecule will attach with this receptor protein, okay, then some sort of chemical reaction will take place inside the cytoplasm. Understand? So this is a kind of receptors. So first one was semi permeable membrane.